Oh iya, kalau saya tak cakap sama Mami, memang banyak tak cucuk vaksin.
Squad kita akan pergi rumah ke rumah dan menerangkan betapa perlunya untuk ambil vaksin ini.
Lepas tu orang yang tak ada transport, hantarlah orang.
Chop, no chop, back.
I have had more than 1,000 people got their vaccine.
Hampir 5,000 orang kita berjaya bawa keluar mereka untuk dapatkan vaksin.
Around 300 to 400.
105 orang.
Almost 10,000.
Easily we could have touched 10,000.
And I become very famous after vaccination.
Okay, saya bersama dengan keluarga saya, kami meninggalkan kampung halaman sekitar tahun 82.
I came to Malaysia in 1993.
Malaysia saya datang tu tahun 92.
Tahun berapa ya saya sudah lupa, agak-agak 15 tahun lah.
Personalnya juga, masyarakat di Malaysia.
Saya datang dari Indonesia, dari Jawa Timur.
My grandfather came from Fujian.
My great-grandparents are from Sri Lanka.
I know that some of my descendants are from Thailand.
Pasal dulu orang tua saya bahagiakan saya sekarang, buat yang bahagiakan orang tua saya sekarang.
Dibantu sama saya, mungkin mak saya dengan anak saya senanglah.
In 2013-14 in Nepal there are many strikes, business everything lost. So my friends they told me come to Malaysia and work.
Because of war and like the conditions in China was really bad at that time. So he traveled by boat to Malaysia.
Tentera Myanmar datang, dia menangkap anak-anak muda ni untuk tujuan yang kita tidak pasti.
Somali house to get the jira au geli gawro la shida Malaysia jukti. Malaysia jogitan ke jukta anu ku aku farxana aku soo bax Somali dibka dagaalada ka jiro iyo aan ka soo cararay.
Kasihan orang sini kan, orang sini dulu tak kerja. Yang pertama itu 4 bulan. Yang mau makan pun susah. Lagi yang barusan itu 3 bulan. Lagian ada mau orang cucuk vaksin. Terus tak ada duit. Saya kasihan lah.
Jadi mula-mula kerjaan dah vaksin kan. Jadi kami orang asing ni belum dapat vaksin.
3 langkah ke belakang.
Masa itu dekat KL sana ada vaksin juga, tapi kena pergi sana. Lepas tu orang yang tak ada dokumen, dia pergi pun takut. Jadi dia tak pergilah. Kalau tak vaksin, nak kerja pun susah, nak cari makan pun susah.
Having all of them go to one central location was not ideal. You know, migrant workers are not only here in KL. Transportation may not be necessarily accessible.
I believe vaccines should be accessible to everyone. Doesn't matter what group, race, whatever. You know, not just because you're you know, this set of group of people, then we make it tougher for you.
Like a jogger came around this area and then they found this community here, found out that they weren't even vaccinated at all, and then they DM us on Instagram. Then that's when we got in touch with this community and started doing work here with them. Yeah, now you?
The blood you very sweet. I suffer.
Nít nói, nít nói.
Nít nói, nít nói.
It's also Nitoi, man.
Yeah.
Nitoi, Nitoi. Kumbu, muncul lah. Kumbu, muncul lah.
This is got some similar word, but I don't understand also.
So Malaysian Red Crescent, as an auxiliary, we were able to actually provide that support and perspective to the government in how we could execute a vaccination program to cover everyone, regardless of their status, gender and nationality. We knew when we started, it's either the language barrier or you probably need someone close enough to interact with them to get them to come over for vaccination, etc.
Squad kita pergi rumah ke rumah untuk berjumpa dan menerangkan betapa perlunya untuk ambil vaksin ini.
Ini vaksin ini bukan saya minta orang bantu, orang yang minta saya bantu. Jadi orang cam saya dekat kampung tu, dia tahu saya kerja dekat Asada sini. Dia kata, Pak Cali carilah itu vaksin orang kita. Saya tanya lah, ini doktor kan? Dia pergi tahu. Lepas itu doktor pun nak minta pada pihak NGO, minta tolongkan orang asing sini.
So, as you know, we have a lot of Vietnamese immigrant workers here in Malaysia. So we just put up on the Facebook and call them, you know, ask them to register, and we send the list to the Malaysian Red Crescent.
Dan kita akan dapatkan data, daftarkan nama-nama mereka, identiti mereka semua. Kita akan serah pada PPNGO kawan-kawan untuk kita bincang dan bawa ke satu lokasi, kita set up satu PPV dan semua komuniti yang berada di sekitar kawasan Selayang Gombak, mana yang dah ada nama, kita akan dapatkan vaksin untuk dia.
Waxa ay soo xadii waso kaaya markii meel nolo dhaho oo xagga la aadaya qof walba gurigooda ugu tagaa waso wada shaqadan geeya ka badi borderka xira meel walba nidaamka oo meesha cirbada meesha la fadhiisana registrationka biya dadkan biya u qaybiya ka badina waxaan fadhiistaa meesha booskayga oo chok والله وادي عاد وحن وادي عاد وجع هذا بو شوب نو شوب بك راح يعجبه وقفه قفه مال أن لو دي مسؤول قفه سومرة أيه خلاص وقف راح سنة يعني بشق هذا شيء تنقف
itu orang yang tak ada transport, hantarlah orang.
Kami sediakan logistik. Kami akan pergi ambil mereka ini, datang di tempat vaksin dan mengantar pulang.
While working times, many customer, many people came and I asked, you already got your vaccine? So I guide them. I bring in Bukit Bintan, the church also, the local peoples.
Jadi saya cakap sama mem itu kan, di kongsi kamu itu ada yang tak cukup vaksin ya Pak? Ya sih Pak, ada mem banyak tak cukup vaksin. Jadi alhamdulillah banyak yang daftar sama saya, terus sama saya kirim dekat mem lah.
The role of the migrant leaders were extremely, extremely important because we were in touch with the migrant leaders and we gave all the information that the migrant leaders needed. But they were instrumental in convincing their migrant community to come forward and take the vaccination.
I think the key to it to this is the trust building and the confidence giving, you know, for them to step forward. Without the community leaders, this wouldn't have been possible.
as I am human being, so I have to think for every people.
Kita rasa itu terlalu penting untuk kita jaga community kita dan juga community Malaysia ini. Jadi kita juga bertanggungjawab untuk kita juga selamat dan dia juga selamat.
There are people who actually consider Malaysia home but are not born here, for example. They love the places, they love the people, they love the food. They wish well for the nation, they want the country to grow. So that is the shared common destiny that all of us collectively share. We have to embrace the differences and diversities, and if someone wants to belong, let them belong.
والله ماليزيا هذا بلد كي قال واد واي عادي عاد يسو دويسي عادي عاد وحنا لو قواتي ميش حرمنا فديسنا ميش حرمنا مرنا عادي عاد بلد كي قال واد ماليزيا.
So I learned a lot of things in Malaysia. I meet many good friends in Malaysia. The second home is Malaysia.
So home for me is where the family is.
Home is where there is like this connection that I have with the people that is there.
Home to me will always be this country. It has great potential to live out to what Malaysia really should be. And I want to do more for the country.
Saya besar di Malaysia lah. Jadi saya anggap Malaysia juga adalah rumah saya. Negara macam negara saya sendiri. Walaupun saya mungkin tak diiktiraf, tapi pada hati, dari sudut hati saya anggap negara saya. Sebab itu saya bertindak ataupun melakukan semua kerja-kerja ini di kala pandemik ini.